Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Children, during this Advent time, we think about Our Lady's kindness. Our Lady, Blessed Virgin Mary, she is the Mother of God, and our Mother as well. And mothers usually are kind. They like to do so much good for their children, because children are loved so much by their mother. So in a similar way, Blessed Virgin Mary, who is our Mother in heaven, she always watches over us and prays for us and wants us to do good and kind and charitable deeds. The saint of today, whom we celebrate during this octave of Our Lady's Immaculate Conception, is Saint Peter Fourier, and he was certainly one of those very kind and charitable saints. He lived in France in the late 1500s and early 1600s, and he's known as a teacher saint who loved to teach children their catechism and their religion so that they could become good citizens and even better Christians. Saint Peter, that he himself was a great intellectual. That means that he had read lots of books and he knew so much and he was very wise. In fact, Saint Peter knew the whole Summa of Saint Thomas Aquinas by heart, and it is a huge, huge book, multi-volume Magnum Opus, the great work of the philosophy of the Middle Ages. So he was extremely smart and wise, but he was also very kind and charitable. He had been going to the best schools of his own age, and he got excellent grades. And when he graduated, he opened a school of his own. But Saint Peter Fourier was not satisfied just studying and teaching and living a life in the midst of big books. But he wanted to teach those who were most in need and of most necessary doctrine, namely religion. So he moved to be a parish priest in a village, and there he spent for 30 years of his life. He started with the grown-ups because many of them were living very, very bad lives, because they didn't know any better, because the teaching of religion had been so much neglected. So Saint Peter worked and prayed for his people, and he started several holy groups for men, women, and children, where the catechism was taught and the good faith and morals was imprinted into minds of the people. And of children, Saint Peter was especially concerned. He started a congregation of sisters to teach poor children in schools where they could attend for free. And the saint himself taught the sisters how to handle children and what to teach them. He wanted to make sure that the students learned to make bills and write correct letters so that they could get good jobs when they were grown up and when they finished their schooling. And it's noticeable that he took also children from non-Catholic families. And to these non-Catholic children, he told the sisters that they are always to be treated kindly and lovingly. He exhorted, "Do not let the other children tease them. Do not speak harshly of their religion, but rather show how good and reasonable our faith is when you speak to the whole class." And that's a great lesson for us too in our age. If we are good and kind, and we show with our actions that we love Jesus and Mary, the people around us, even those who are not Catholics, they recognize Christ in us and want to imitate God, who has taught us to be so good and kind. Saint Paul himself, and whose letters we have several in the Bible, he writes that if I should have prophecy and knew all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I should have all faith so that I could remove mountains and have not charity, I am nothing. So there you have, children, even if you know all the things in the world, or you are the wisest man or woman there ever lived, if you are not kind with other people, they don't want to be in your company, and also they don't want to hear what you say. So in your lives, imitate Blessed Virgin Mary, who is so wise and who is so kind. You believe in Jesus, you believe everything he has taught to you, and you want to also to prove that faith with your actions. And Our Lady also, she is immaculate. She is free from sin, and that means she's always kind to everybody. So during this octave and during this Advent, pray to her, Blessed Virgin Mary, to make you equally kind to other people, always loving God above everything, and treat your neighbor kindly. May God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.